What is happening, guys? Cowboy here, and welcome to part 3 of the walkthrough for Ashes of Ariandel. So, I didn't go through the items at the end of the last episode, so just to recap, things we picked up, we got the follower saber, which I actually upgraded, and you can see it's a direct upgrade from the falchion, which is quite nice. That was down there on the vines. Aside from that, we picked up a new sorcery as well, Snap Freeze, which creates a cloud of near-freezing mist. This is very similar to things like Acid Surge, Poison Mist, except it is a frostbite-based sorcery instead of, you know, poison or whatever the other case is. And we also picked up a slab, which was taking the ladder all the way up to the area just around the side of this cliff. So, now with those done, we're going to actually continue on to where the game expects you would have gone, and that is over to the Corvian settlement. So the first thing we're going to do is come this way. Now you'll see we got some of our favorite fly people hanging on up here. Now we've encountered these guys a lot, but I haven't said much about them. They're not that deadly. They do have a bleed, so in a later area we're going to want a torch. We actually find a torch right before that area, conveniently enough. An upgraded torch, which we can use to breathe fire on people. But anyway, yeah, go over there, get that Shriving Stone. We're going to round this corner, kill this little bugger real fast. No, you don't. Go suicide for daddy. There you go. And we should have another follower here. Let's use his follower saber against him. I really do love the weapon art on this thing. So it's got this... if you could stop breathing flame, I could show you better, but I'll just kill him and then show you it. So anyway, what makes this weapon so fantastic, we gotta wind up and then we can heavy attack. But the delay on that can be immense, so just to showcase that better, that's with instant versus... Look at that. We held that for about 2 seconds before dropping it out. It's nuts, right? So anyway, now we are going to snowboard. Reminds me of Final Fantasy VII. So much fun. Anyway, we're going to go around here and get a... let me check my notes. Budding Green Blossom, maybe? No. Hero item. Snowboarding. Yes, soul item. Okay, so we're going to take the top path, and that's where we'll find our green blossoms. So, you can go bottom or top. There's really no reason to go bottom. We're going to drop down there. Approaching from the top just lets us kill a couple enemies on the way, so we can see our first guy right here. Weird, decrepit bird people. And the enemies in particular, they're very, very slow. Like, almost... I would go as far as to say that they're almost not even a threat because of how slow they are. So you can just kind of walk around and slap them. Even if you do aggro all of them, by the time they stand up, they're not really an issue. And these are the, these are four-born. So, these are the past inhabitants of this area. Now, there's an item up here. It's actually a really cool weapon. We're going to get that in a little bit. Don't have to kill them. If you want, kill them. It doesn't make a massive difference. But anyway, after them, we're going to pass through here. And we're going to encounter... and then we're going to run into our first Corvian Knight. Now, these guys can be quite tricky. There's two types of them. There are Claw Corvian Knights, and then there are the Crow Wing Corvian Knights, which use, like, a Rapier-Claw combo. They can do a lot of damage if you're not careful. They can be parried. They can also be stagger-locked. As you can see, they can do a lot of damage. Oh my god, I don't have any, I used it all up on previous casts. Wow, apparently they're quite resistant to fire, so we're gonna... just gonna stagger them down. We might actually die here. It gave my bleed build a fair amount of difficulty. Strength just annihilated them, but looks like we got the backstep. So I know that you're probably already thinking, please tell me I can get that crow's weapons. As you can see, putting it in a corner, staggering it down is actually pretty easy. We can't get access to their armor, but we do get that weapon, and that's coming up in just a second. So we got our sharp gem off him. We got another soul item here. a couple of these dudes, and we're going to continue up this ladder. Now, some of these guys will breathe poison. Namely, you can see the white ones. We're going to call those the little Corvians. The bigger Corvians, the black ones. Every now and then, you'll have one which will put a toxic cloud towards you, so just something to be aware of. Anyway, come on in here. We're going to grab the item. And then we got a guy over here. Now, do not kill this NPC. This guy is he's chill.
Well, there is nothing forlorn about you.
Anyway, tell him you're Ash. Run through all of your dialogue. And after you've exhausted the dialogue, you just leave. But later, after we've beaten the next boss, we come back, and this guy's going to give us a slap. If you have beaten the boss, he won't be right there. He'll actually be right here. So, something to keep in mind. Free slap for just keeping him alive. Well, not even keeping him alive, just not killing him, really. So, anyway, we're going to go to the building here to the left, get our bonfire. And now we're going to do a couple of loops real fast. So, probably a dumb idea to rest, because I'm going to have to run past that Corvian Knight. Shouldn't have rested. Don't rest. Don't do what I did. Anyway, take the ladder, or the bridge, excuse me, and curve stay real tight to the left here. We're going to go all the way around. You can see one of our toxic Corvians there. Or a toxic follower, excuse me. Now, you can drop down and get that if you want. Looking at my notes, jump off the bridge. Yes, a simple gem. We will just to make sure it's also a simple gem on new game. Or new game plus, excuse me. Yes, simple gem. You can open this up. Interestingly enough, this is actually an invasion. People can't invade you when you're right in this spot. Something to keep in mind. And we'll run back through. And this is actually not a bad idea, because now I can show you stagger lock against the Corvian Knight. Now you can see, get him in a corner, and you can just really R1 to your heart's content. I mean, he's still just as deadly if you let him get up on you, but you know, we literally just spam the shit out of R1, so if it comes down to it and you're having trouble with him, do that, and you'll be just fine. So anyway, I just got turned around terribly. Yeah, we're going to go this way. We're going to take that same path we did, except instead of jumping down to get the simple gem, we're going to get the crow claws, which are the weapon you just saw that guy using. Crow talons, excuse me. So we're not going to rest this time, just because he will respawn, and we're going to have to be running back in a moment. But once again, just go across the bridge. Stick to your left here. Watch out for the poison guy. Go up. And then kill these two, just because they could potentially mess up your jump. Kill this one if you want. Doesn't really matter, but might as well. We're going to jump this gap, so go across there. Beautiful. We'll grab this item. That's our bonfire right down there. Now there's going to be this guy right around the corner waiting to ambush you. Just run around. Give him a good old backstab. Wait for that poison mist. We're going to go this way to get a crystal lizard. Little shit. Not getting away. These lizards are ripping me off, man. Large titanite. Which is odd, because on my other run they were dropping twinkling, so I don't know why they're dropping large now. But anyway, on to the crow quills. Not the claws. We're getting the quills right now. Which you haven't seen that weapon yet, but you'll see it in action just a second here. From an enemy, actually. So, right up here, you look across, you can see that item from before. Run, jump, and you got the crow quills. So this is a dex-focused weapon. It starts with the EC. Pretty nice weapon, all in all. It has a rapier-style moveset, real fast, just to kind of show things off a little bit with it. You can see regular. It's like your basic rapier. If we use the L2, we'll jump up and throw out claws, which isn't that strong, but I found it's actually nice to finish somebody off. Kind of just like a better version of throwing knives. But the real beauty of this thing is when we press L1. You can see we now have like a combination of attacks between the claw and the rapier. So, pretty interesting moveset. I think we're going to end up seeing a lot of this in PvP, as you can see. I mean, it is upgraded, but that damage was terrible. But it's very, very offensive weapon. You know, we have like an advancing attack where we're, you know, constantly pushing up on the enemy with that weapon. So I think it's going to be a big favorite of PvPers. Anyway, let me run back through. Let me check my notes here. Ember, do not kill. Straight through. Yes, okay. So now we are going to cross the bridge. There's going to be a bunch of bird people on the ground. You can just ignore them. And a knight's going to pop out in a second and fight us. We're not going to deal with him. There he is right there. But this is the turn we want. So go through here. There's going to be a couple guys right around the corner. Whole place is kind of like an ambush city. Just expect. Yeah, you can see another guy just fell down. This one is a poison breather. The lesser ones can also breathe poison, but it takes them a lot longer to actually do it. So by the time they could have hit you with it, you're usually well and gone. So now we're gonna go up this. We're gonna drop down first. Go in here, take this down. We're gonna open up a shortcut. So very minor shortcut. There's the bridge. There's the bonfire. All right, now we're going to go back up. We're going to take out these guys before we worry about the item over there. So run across. Take this up. These are the special bird, or the forlorn sorcerers. As you can see, they're not really a giant threat. They're just kind of more annoying than anything. And there we have our crow talons. So now we'll drop down and pick this up. And just to show off the crow talons, another dex weapon, that's what we saw the guy using, has built-in bleed. Standard moveset is that of your regular claws. Our L2, however, you basically, it's like Berserker Barrage Wolverine. So definitely a really cool look on these. I think they're going to be a new favorite of bleed-based builds. Put that back on. All right, now that we got that, we're going to just drop down, climb back up this ladder. We've got another ambush around this corner. Another one right behind me right now. But he's kind of slow. Now we're going to go in here. You can go down here. You should do this first. Yeah. We're going to go down. This is the Slave Knight armor set. We're going to want to grab that. And if that looks slightly familiar, I have so many armors. If you look at this, this is actually the same armor set that the guy that sucked us into the painting was wearing. So anyway, open up this. This is the second house that's locked. There's house one. There's our bonfire. Once again, we're going to go in here, up the ladder, and we're going to go around again. Same, up, drop, climb. Now, in a previous episode, I made mention of rapport and how it is a very nice spell to have in this DLC. And we actually have the main area coming up, which is like the reason why I felt it was good to have along. So I'll show you that in just a moment. But we got a crystal lizard over here. But before we go all crazy running for him, it's important to note that right above him, you can see him up there, we have another dude. So let me see if I can... That's not going to work. I need to use a bow to get him. And the crystal lizard is gone. So let's just prepare to toast this guy. Come and get me. Only real thing to be super careful about is that attack, and then of course watch out for the bleed build up. Pretty easy to get bleed built up and die from that. But anyway, so we're gonna go over here, drop down. I never noticed all this before. Nasty. Anyway, onto the previous roof. Jump across, and here's some gold coins. Now, we do have one more Corvian Knight below. You can basically just ignore him. He's not going to do anything. He's not really a threat to us. But so we're going to go this way. You can hear him down there getting all uppity and tossing stuff around. Soul item here on the roof. I think there's... Let me see. Yes, okay. So after that soul item, we're going to go through this window. We can get another item, but we got to walk through this window very slowly. You can walk through one of the other ones, but this is just the easier one to get through. Right there on the rafters. And you see there's a Claw Corvian. There is a Crow Talon Corvian. So the reason I suggest you bring report along is here we can... hit him, and then piss this one off. Well, looks like he doesn't want to go down. We need to get him to go down. Let me try and hit him with the chaos. That might make him go down. I really just want him to fall off the catwalk. There we go. And now they fight in mortal combat. That wasn't really a fair battle. I mean, the other guy did catch a frickin' great chaos to the face. Now you can drop down. Now he is here. Oh, wow, they're still alive. That's cute. Oh. I thought my report hit him. It did not. So yeah, he can be really, really brutal. You don't gotta worry about the bleed, but unlike the when you saw us using the weapon and we were like tickling people with those knives, his knives will take out like massive chunks of your health. So same as before though, they can be stagger locked. You can't just put them into a corner and kind of abuse them. As you can see there, the knives doing just big old chunks of damage. Kind of like unnecessarily high amounts, I think, but. Oh, wow, I did not know they could do a riposte. That's actually kind of like, I'm not even mad. I'm more just impressed. So, anyway, take them down. Get our new miracle, Way of the White Corona. Summons beers. And then after that... yes, okay, we're going to open the chapel gate next. And then we got one more fight, and then we're at a bonfire. So around this area, there's basically an ambush. I'm not sure why they put it in, but just to show it to you guys, because I'm sure somebody's going to be like, well, why didn't we go back there? Yeah. Not sure why they're there. I guess it's just hoping people will wander into it and get messed up. Anyway. Over here. Open this on up. You can see our other Corvian Knight kind of creeping down there. There's that crystal lizard. It looks like it actually... Is that the one from before? Or is that a different one? I don't know, but I want to get it now. it's running. No, you don't, you little bastard. It's gonna get away. It's gonna get away. It's gone. It got away. That makes me sad. Really don't have time for this guy. Another thing I didn't mention, you can also parry these Corvian Knight guys, so feel free to if you're confident in your parrying abilities. Anyway, we're gonna go on up here. We got a couple frosty trees. You can see the first frosty tree right here in front of us. I think this one might be a frosty tree as well. It is. Two frost trees. We got one more around the cathedral. White branch and two rusted coins. You can see it like, ooh, there's an item. Let me walk up and grab that. Don't do that. Beat the tree down first. Now grab your young white branch. And tuck in the corner here. Get the rusted coin. Now, if you remember, there was kind of that, like, douchey guy that called us a mad bastard earlier. We're about to fight him. Now, he uses a greatsword. It's pretty easy to parry because he one-hands it the majority of the fight. But it can be a little tricky. He can hit, like, a truck. That's the main thing to look out for. You can see him right there.
I've seen your kind.
Time and time again.
Every fleeing man must be caught. Every secret must be unearthed. Such is the conceit of the self-proclaimed seeker of truth. But in the end, you lack the stomach.
Did he just silence me? He did! I'm not even mad. Oh, God. And wow, I just got absolutely scrubbed on by him. And now he's going to heal. You know what? I'm not even mad because when I wrote this guide, I did not know he had the ability to silence. So like in all the other builds I fought, I wasn't a caster. So that's an important piece of information. I mean, as you can see right there, we were able to just absolutely chunk his health. So we're going to do the same thing again, except this time, once he gets low enough, we're just going to go up and finish the job. So anyway, if you sprint through, you should be fine. The Corvian Knight also attacks the Forlorn, as you can see right there. So, oh my god, why is he hitting me so freaking hard all of a sudden? I don't know what that was all about, but anyway, run on in. I don't think he'll follow us into the cathedral. Yeah, it looks like, oh no, it looks like he will. So, circle around, backstab abuse. Let me tell you about backstab abuse. No! Oh my god. Good thing I embered before I got here, otherwise I would have been in trouble. So, on to douchebag.
Your kind. Time and time again.
Oh wow, he got smarter. Did you see that shit? He just silenced me right at the start this time. You wanna play the silence game? We can play the silence game. Actually, it looks like that silence just fell off, so. Gonna keep trying to heal. Feel free to just nuke him through it.
Forgive me, my lady.
I mean, we just scrubbed all over him, but I will give it to him. That was some awesome play there. With him freaking the guard break into the instant kill, that was nuts. So anyway, you get the contraption key from him and a new weapon. Really, really cool weapon at that. The Onyx Blade, one of the weapons I want to use for this. It's a dark weapon. It has built-in dark damage, EEDD, very low stat requirements on that. Real excited to see what the potential of this thing is fully upgraded. But run up here. And here
I
we go.
Scent of Ash.
We gotta show her the flame. This is just some little girl who's going to paint. Don't worry about her for now. She says some crazy plot stuff later. We're going to come out here, and we're going to open this. That's back to the little girl. And there's our bonfire. And that is a wrap. So the little girl, if you remember, back at the cathedral, I said there's an NPC you'll talk to later. That's actually her. She's up the stairs, or up the ladder, I should say. Really interesting dialogue if you're a fan of lore. But anyway, so to recall what we got this episode, we picked up the crow quills. That was from jumping that gap onto that small platform. We got the crow talons. That was found on top of the roof. And then we picked up the onyx blade, and that was from killing Wilhelm. So just to kind of showcase the onyx blade, because we didn't get a chance to show the other ones. Run-of-the-mill greatsword. You know, nice moveset going vertical with it. Probably the cooler thing, though. Yes. Like, the chaos flame. Or the black flame, I should say. So, just to, I mean, given it's unupgraded, just to run through some stats. It's at 270 right now. We do the upgrade with it. Put on the flame. And it goes up to 418. So this is at 418 right now. And that is without any upgrades, which is pretty nuts, to be honest. Because this is 478. 418 while it's buffed. So, as you can imagine, getting that thing to plus 5, it'll probably be pretty devastating. I'm actually going to do that before the next episode, just to kind of see what it's capable of. So anyway, guys, that wraps up part 3. Moving forward from here, we got to go through a Snowy Hills area, and then we have the last boss of the game. So make sure to stay tuned, and then we'll catch you with part 4.